Mandibular ligament. The mandibular ligament is an osteocutaneous ligament that arises from the anterior third of the mandible and inserts directly into the dermis. Its fibers penetrate the inferior portion of the depressor anguli oris muscle. Furness introduced the mandibular ligament as a linear series of parallel fibers, 2 to 3 millimeters from each other, located 1 centimeter from the inferior border of the mandible, along its anterior third, interdigitate among the muscle fibers of the platysma and triangularis along their line of attachment to the mandible. Stusen et al. Describe the mandibular ligaments as osteocutaneous, which securely fix the parasymphyseal dermis to the underlying mandible, and illustrated it as a smaller stout ligament. Oshtemir et al. Reported two mandibular ligaments with mean widths of 22 to 32 mm, and confirmed histologically the connection between the periosteum and overlying skin. Mendelssohn et al. Reported it in the subplatysmal plane. The mandibular ligament is located immediately in front of the masseter's anterior border. Hutner et al. Described two ligaments in the subcutaneous plane. The mandibular osteocutaneous ligament, MOCL, with a mean width of 13 mm, and the platysma mandibular ligament, PML, with a mean width of 22 mm. Kong et al. Described two mandibular ligaments and one mental ligament in the subplatysmal plane. Langevin et al. Reported on the dimensions of the mandibular ligaments measuring 2 cm horizontally times 1.2 cm verticali and located 4.5 cm anterior to the angle of the mandible. Rees et al. Identified another osteocutaneous ligamentous structure that travels as a posterior extension of the mandibular ligament originating 1 cm superior to the border of the mandible. They named this structure the mandibular septum. This septum extends from the mandibular ligament anteriorly and ends abruptly posteriorly at another vertical septum that forms the anterior border of the lateral temporal cheek fat compartment. Clinical significance. A. This painting by William Scrotts, 1546, displays the young teenage future matriarch, Elizabeth, with a full face and flawless skin. B. This portrait painting by Marcus Geraerts the Younger, late 1590s, of an older Queen Elizabeth I depicts marked facial weathering and volume loss with a thinning face and extensive ridded formation. Facial aging results from a combination of soft tissue descent and volumetric deflation. The loss of tissue elasticity combined with repetitive motion from muscle contraction and gravity is believed to cause tissue descent. The role of the retaining ligaments in this process is not well defined. Some authors believe that laxity of the retaining ligaments results in laxity and descent of the soft tissue they support. Another school of thought suggests that the ligaments remain relatively strong while the unsupported tissue in between, in the spaces and compartments, descends with time. This phenomenon is responsible for the stigmata of facial aging, manifested in bulges and grooves. Stigmata of facial aging as they relate to retaining ligaments of the face in the form of grooves. The most notable signs of aging is the nasogical groove and its lateral extension, the palpebromalar groove. These grooves correspond to the location of the tear trough ligament and orbicularis retaining ligament, respectively, and mark the location of the lid-cheek junction. As the orbital septum attenuates with age, the periorbital fat bulges anteriorly against the septum and inferiorly against the orbicularis retaining ligament. The formation of this bulge, combined with volumetric deflation in the upper cheek, leads to accentuation and visibility of the orbicularis retaining ligament at the lid-cheek junction. Kikawa et al. Suggested that the orbitomalar ligament, or orbicularis retaining ligament, distends and stretches with aging, which would theoretically lower the lid-cheek junction. This, however, contradicts Lambrose's findings that the lid-cheek junction is remarkably stable in position over time. The ligament's V-shape is due to non-uniform length, distance from the orbital rim to muscle insertion, which allows the longest portion at the apex of the V to distend more. Another classic stigmata of facial aging is formation of jowls, formed by the descent of the premaseteric space, which overlies the lower portion of the masseter. According to Reese et al., the superior and inferior jowl fat compartments descend, secondary to attenuation of the mandibular septum. Either way, as the jowl forms, its anterior extension is limited by the mandibular ligament. The groove that forms just anterior to the jowl corresponds to the mandibular ligament. Another unique aspect of the mandibular ligament is that its subcutaneous extension, retinacular cutis, can cause skin indentation with aging. Failure to recognize and correct this deformity by subcutaneous release can lead to patient dissatisfaction after facelift surgery. Role of the retaining ligaments in aging face. Anatomical location of the retaining ligaments. 1. Parotid cutaneous ligaments. 2. Masseteric ligaments. 3. Mandibular ligament. 4. Zygomatic ligaments. 5. Orbital retaining ligaments. Bulges and grooves develop with aging on the skin surface in accordance with presence of the retaining ligaments. The effect of face lifts on the retaining ligament. A. The normal aging process involves soft tissue sagging with attenuation of the retaining ligament. During, B. Subcutaneous plane face lift or, C. Superficial musculoponeurotic system face lift, injury to the retaining ligament is inevitable. D. The double plane face lift with subperiosteal and subcutaneous plane dissection can minimize injury to the retaining ligaments. Blue arrows indicate the movement of soft tissue. SMAS, superficial musculoponeurotic system. Conclusions. The retaining ligaments of the face are important landmarks that occupy predictable anatomic locations. When performing facial aesthetic surgery, plastic surgeons should decide on a plane of dissection, release the appropriate ligaments depending on the desired aesthetic goals, and avoid nerve injury by using the ligaments as anatomic landmarks. Clarification of the anatomic definitions of the facial retaining ligaments and knowledge of their location, function, and proximity to the SMAS and facial nerves should add to the safety and efficacy of facial aesthetic surgery. Final thoughts. The retaining ligaments act as markers to the position of the facial nerve branches in the cheek. The zygomatic and buccal branches emerge from the masseteric fascia and cross the sub-SMAS plane to the underside of the SMAS. The ligaments therefore retain the overlying SMAS and protect the facial nerve branches as they cross this glide plane. In facial rejuvenation surgery, the deep plane method achieves a tightening of the medial cheek soft tissues. After the retaining ligaments are released, the superficial fascia can be drawn posteriorly. The facial nerve branches are simultaneously identified and preserved during surgical ligament release. One of the most fascinating aspects of the anatomy of the retaining ligaments of the face is their spatial relationship to facial nerve branches. The inferior temporal septum is a landmark for the temporal branches of the facial nerve that pass just medial and parallel. These branches travel in close proximity to the undersurface of the superficial temporal fascia and are elevated with the flap. Approaching and releasing the inferior temporal septum should be a warning sign for the surgeon to slow down and perform careful dissection, making sure to stay down on the deep temporal fascia. The orbitomolar ligament has an intimate relationship to the zygomaticofacial nerve branches located just inferior to the lateral aspect of the ligament. The zygomatic retaining ligaments are landmarks for the zygomatic facial nerve branches. Furness was the first to show that a zygomatic branch passes in a deep plane just inferior to the zygomatic ligament. A recent study showed that the main zygomatic and upper masseteric retaining ligaments, located at a mean of 11 mm from each other, create a pathway where an upper zygomatic nerve passes in a deep plane, 4 mm deep to the deep fascia. A lower zygomatic nerve passes just inferior to or penetrates the upper masseteric ligament at a more superficial level, 1 mm deep to the deep fascia, and pierces the deep fascia just distal to the ligament. The masseteric ligaments are important landmarks for the buccal facial nerve branches. These ligaments guard the nerves, which penetrate the deep fascia and become superficial on top of the buccal fat pad, just distal to the masseteric ligaments. In other words, releasing the masseteric retaining ligaments in a sub-SMAS plane may cause herniation and exposure of the buccal fat pad, with the buccal facial branches lying superficial to it. Langevin et al. Described the relationship of the marginal mandibular nerve to the mandibular ligaments. In 20 hemiphases, the nerve was found to run just posterior to the mandibular ligament. Finally, the great auricular nerve is anatomically related to the subcutaneous extension of the platysmauricular ligament.